Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. A horrified mother has slammed travel agent TUI after she was reportedly taken to a creepy rehab facility when her flight was cancelled. Hayley Whybrow, 37, claims she and her family were bussed for half an hour outside the Turkish city of Antalya to a dark hotel without signs in scenes reminiscent of horror film The Shining. She said the 20 people who had their flight to London Stansted Airport cancelled started shouting and screaming when they saw the Acre Vital Park Hotel, which they later discovered was a facility for drug and alcohol addicts. Mrs. Whybrow demanded she and her family be taken back to the airport to spend the night there instead. Hayley Whybrow, pictured second from left with partner Sean, daughter Amy and son Harry, has slammed travel agent TUI after she was reportedly taken to a creepy rehabilitation facility. The family were taken to the Acre Vital Hotel outside Antalya in Turkey at 3 a.m. when their flight to London Stansted Airport was cancelled, only to find a mini riot outside the hotel. Pictured, around 20 tourists were driven half an hour by coach to the hotel in the middle of the night. Pictured, on July the 28th, the mother of two, from Marks'tay in Essex, said, "It was like being in a nightmare. It was chaos. There were people screaming and shouting. My daughter started having a panic attack because she was so scared. I was crying. The place was very creepy. It was like something out of The Shining." Mrs. Whybrow soon discovered the hotel also ran programs for drug and alcohol addicts. On the resort's website, it refers to itself as a healthy lifestyle and clinical hotel, which provides addict rehabilitation, physiotherapy and family counseling, among other services. The family refused to stay in the hotel after seeing the condition of its exterior, and demanded to be taken back to the airport. Mrs. Whybrow later discovered the Acre Vital Park Hotel, pictured, also offered rehabilitation programs for drug and alcohol addicts alongside physiotherapy and family counseling. The 20 tourists taken to the hotel started screaming and shouting when they saw the creepy surroundings, pictured, a program outline found on the hotel's website. The family had been due to fly at 1 a.m. on Saturday, July the 28th, but were instead ushered onto a coach after a three-hour flight delay. Mrs. Whybrow, who had been on holiday with daughter Amy, 19, son Harry, 8, and partner Sean Creekor, 37, said, "When we were coming back on Friday, we got to the airport, went through check-in and were told nothing was wrong. Then a three-hour delay came up on the screen. We knew there were quite heavy storms, so we had prepared ourselves for that. We heard a TUI announcement calling my name to the gate, and when we got there at 2:30 a.m. we were told our flight had been cancelled. My family and around 20 other people were just led out to a coach, and a man with a TUI t-shirt said they were taking us to a hotel 20 minutes out of the city. They didn't tell us the name of the place or anything. We drove for what felt like an hour and everyone was getting worried about how long we had been driving. We thought, what kind of hotel are they taking us to? It was nowhere near a city, it was in the outback." Mrs. Whybrow said when she arrived, she immediately felt uncomfortable due to a mini riot outside the hotel. She refused to hand over her family's passports and immediately demanded to be taken back to the airport. Mrs. Whybrow said, "When we finally got to this hotel, there was no signage. It was just a building in the middle of nowhere." TUI has since apologized for the delayed flight and confirmed the accommodation had been sourced at short notice. Pictured, the road to the Acre Vital Park facility. "There was a mini riot going on, and this was without knowing it was a drug and alcohol rehab center. We couldn't get to the desk to speak to anyone. It was actually really scary, and we had no phone signal because it was so far out. People had been asked to hand in their passports, but I refused. There were a few people who had said, 'This isn't good enough. We're going back to the airport.' There were children in our group and it was scary for them." The next day, Mrs. Whybrow discovered from customers who stayed at the hotel that it was actually a rehabilitation facility that catered for drug and alcohol addicts. She said, "It was only later when we saw people who did stay there said it was a rehab facility. I can't imagine how a company like TUI can send people there. But when we spoke to people the next day, they said there were IV drips in the rooms and lines coming out of the walls. I think if I had checked in and got to the room, I would have freaked out." Another woman said she'd tried to find breakfast in the morning and there was someone in a wheelchair with a cannula in their hand. A spokesperson for TUI confirmed the accommodation had been sourced at short notice and that this is a rare event. A statement said, "We would like to apologize to Mrs. Whybrow and her family for the delay to their flight from Antalya, Turkey to Stansted on the 27th of July 2018. This was due to the delayed inbound flight which then impacted crew hours. We sourced accommodation at short notice for those customers affected. We will be contacting Mrs. Whybrow directly to discuss and understand her complaint in greater detail. We would like to reassure customers that instances such as this are rare." Mail Online attempted to contact Acre Vital Park for comment and it appeared their phone line had been disconnected.